An Academy. Let's crack it.
Hi guys, I'm Karthike Pathak, CLAT 2016 All India Rank 17 holder. I basically hail from Jaipur and I recently completed my undergraduate BLLB honors from National Law School of India University, Bangalore. So I will be going live for an interactive session regarding how to prepare for CLAT examination and generally on life in the law school on June 12th at 8 PM with Ayushi Rajput, who is one of the top educators on An Academy CLAT and an NLU graduate herself. Now in this particular video, I'll be taking you through my CLAT journey and also my 5 years at the law school. So different people have different motivations for choosing law as a career path. For me, it was not law per se that led me to appear for CLAT exam. However, it was the other way around. One of the biggest factors that led me towards appearing for CLAT exam was my sister and the study material that she used to refer to during her preparation time. Now, during my school days, I was an avid quizzer and I always used to look up to general knowledge stuff and used to read them thoroughly. So therefore, I was naturally drawn towards this CLAT exam primarily because of general knowledge as a subject. Now, however, it was only in 12th that I started to prepare somewhat seriously for the exam. I had ordered some course books from Shriram Coaching and did self-study until my boards exams. I did join a coaching institute in Jaipur after my boards. However, in CLAT 2015, I was not able to secure a good rank and I knew that I had to take a year drop for basically getting into the top 5 NLUs. So therefore, my main preparation stage came about in my drop year. So I used to attend the classes in the morning and by afternoon I would start with my study schedule. Though I was not very strict about my schedule, I consistently averaged about 4 to 5 hours of study per day apart from coaching. Now though there are going to be such days where merely an hour or two of study is possible or even where you are not able to study at all. However, the important thing is that you make up for the delay by chipping in extra study hours on subsequent days. Hence, I feel that instead of slogging towards the end when the CLAT exam is very near, like 2-3 months before the exam, one needs to maintain a consistent approach throughout the 1 year period or 2 year period as the case may be, during which he or she prepares for the exam. So I used to allocate my weekdays for studying different subjects and used to take up 2 subjects per day for 2 hours each. Now on the weekends I used to revise the stuff and focus more on current affairs of the last 2 months, as our coaching used to conduct mock tests on Monday. So I usually brushed up whatever I have read in the prior week and also the current affairs on the weekends. Also, I believe that the mock tests are equally valuable in contributing towards your preparation, not only in terms of increasing the knowledge base, but also in tackling the time management during the exam. They may also help in building your reading speed. Now, I attempted somewhere around 40 mock tests, which helped me finalize my attempting strategy. So I used to take up the GK section at first, and then I used to complete it in about 8 to 10 minutes. So therefore, it used to kind of give me a head start and a confidence booster that I really needed to attempt the other 4 sections. Now, it is important that you specifically allocate time for each section and then immediately move to the next section once the time for one particular section is over. So you really need to attempt almost the entire paper and not just your strongest sections, because it is in your weaker sections that others might take an edge over you. Also, with the changed pattern of the CLAT exam, newspaper reading has become an indispensable part of the preparation. Now, in the legal GK, as you know, the passage-based questions are being asked directly from newspapers. Therefore, it is important to know what all news items are to be covered from the newspaper, like whatever newspaper you read, either the Hindu or the Indian Express. So, for instance, you need to avoid news that cover the political tussles or any political developments while focusing more on policy, legislative and constitutional news items. Now, rest of the news items such as the sports news, the world news, state news, etc. can be read once but not very much thoroughly, as they anyways would be covered in the current affairs magazine or whatever the current affairs notes that have been provided to you by the coaching. Now, the materials that you are referring to should also be limited and relevant. For instance, if I take the case of current affairs, so during my preparation, I relied on 3 sources and kept on revising and re-revising them only. So I basically referred to my coaching notes, the MCQ section on the GK Today website, and also the Competition and Focus magazine. Now, this strategy similarly holds true for any other subject. So you cannot go about practicing the 3 books in the reasoning, such as the R.S. Agarwal, M.K. Pandey, and Arihant, as then you would be devoting too much of time on reasoning with relatively very less increasing benefits. Hence, the logical approach here would be to keep the resources limited and then correct your approach based on whatever the mistakes you have made, and then getting the right concepts and then re-revising these questions. While I believe that self-study is more important rather than solely relying on any particular coaching, now joining an institute might be helpful for those people who struggle with their schedules. And apart from that, coaching may also help in clearing certain concepts and doubts. So if you are really enrolled into any offline or online coaching, then the teachers there may prove to be helpful if you are having any doubts and any questions or conceptual clarity, or if you need conceptual clarity, then coaching may be helpful in such at such times. Nowadays, it has become easier to gain the accessibility to tutors, preparatory materials, and mock tests with the onset of online education platforms. So there is quality content available on YouTube or Unacademy and other platforms for all the subjects, and really at very nominal prices. So this, I believe, is a shift away from the conception that one needs to share out more money in order to access the legal education, and also in order to gain a good education through such coaching institute that are really charge hefty money or anything like that. So this has also brought about a change in the demography of law school students, which now increasingly come from all over the country and also from different economic and social backgrounds. Now, I shall come to my 5-year journey at the National Law School and how it really helped me in shaping my career options, and now what finally I chose to be my career option, how the law school life affected all those things. Now, at the very outset, I would like to say that my 5-year at the law school was no less than any roller coaster ride. As the first year, the very first few weeks of the law school felt like a really tiresome and a long train journey that would end up after the period of 5 years would get over. The days were fully packed up from the classes that used to happen from the morning till the afternoon, and then the orientation sessions that went on till evening. And then there were some of the other events for the first year, such as the treasure hunt, icebreaking events for getting familiar with the campus, the seniors and the batchmates. So though it took me a while to settle in such a different atmosphere, it really helped me in getting the much needed exposure to the outside world. Now, coming to National Law School. A National Law School can be said to be famous or maybe infamous for its academic rigor. With a trimester system in place and 4 subjects to be tackled per trimester, it can get really hectic in the first 2 years with 4 project submissions and then writing 8 exams in a span of 3 months. Now, however, apart from academics, there are ample of opportunities in terms of co-curricular and extracurricular activities that one may look forward to exploit. So when it comes to the student-run committees, they fall under 2 broad categories, namely the activity-based committees and the non-activity-based committees. So the co-curricular activities such as mooting, negotiations, mediation, debating and quizzing are handled by different activity-based committees, such as the Moot Court Society, ADR Board, Literary and Debating Society, etc. So a first or a second year student generally applies as a junior co-opt and then later on go on to become a member of the same committee. Now, apart from this, there are the hostel committees, which are generally tasked with the maintenance of the students' affairs within the hostel as well as within the campus premises. Now, in terms of extracurricular activities, there are various inter and intra-NLU events that takes place on a regularly basis, such as the Spiritus, which is the inter-NLU sports event, the Strawberry Fields Music Fest, and the University Week that happens towards the end of the academic year. And it is something, it is one event that is like most look forward to in the law school life. Hence, the life at law school is not only about academics and studying all the time, but it is quite happening as well due to various events and various activities happening in the committees. It really keeps one engaging throughout his 5-year period. So I personally have received a great exposure in my time at law school, as I have taken part in organizing different events, being a part of the hostel committees, being a member of the National Law School volleyball team, participating in quizzes at the inter-college level, and also in ADR events such as client counseling and negotiation that took place within the college. Now, coming lastly to my further career plans. So one thing that the law school had made me realize is that your career options do not really end when you narrow down to law as your career option, but they just begin at that particular stage. So there are vast options even after one chooses to pursue BA LLB honors degree. Now, it can no longer be seen that the law degree is something that is limited to corporate job or pursuing a career in litigation. So the field of competitive exams such as the State Judicial Services Examination or the Civil Services Examination also find many takers within the law school community. So in my first and second year, I had made up my mind to either try for the Civil Services Examination or any other government law examination such as the SEBI exam, etc. However, I was able to narrow down on my decision to go for Civil Services Examination thanks to the various talks that were conducted by student committees in the college campus itself that hosted the retired civil servants and also law graduate candidates who have recently cleared the Civil Services Examination. So it really provided me an insight as to what kind of a job profile I am seeking for, and how the candidates that have successfully opted for Civil Services Examination after graduating from law background, how is their preparation strategy, what optional subject did they choose, law optional or any other optional. So all these questions I really seek to know the answers to, and somewhere or the other I got the clarity regarding this through these talks only. Now, so that's it for this video. So do join me live on 12th of June at 8 PM for the interactive session with the Unacademy CLAT educator Ayushi. So if you have any particular questions regarding the CLAT exam or generally regarding the life at law school, then do comment down on this video below, or you may even put up the questions during the live session. And also do follow the Unacademy CLAT channel on YouTube for accessing more such sessions. Thank you.